फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द सिंपल एंड इजी कॉन्सेप्ट, बट द सेम कॉन्सेप्ट इज मोस्ट कंफ्यूजिंग टॉपिक अमोंग बैंकिंग एस्पिरेंट्स. इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर बैंक एग्जाम्स, डेफिनेटली स्पीड, एक्यूरेसी अलॉन्ग विद दीज टू पॉइंट्स, सो टाइम मैनेजमेंट, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो टू मेंटेन गुड एक्यूरेसी और 100% एक्यूरेसी, सो विदाउट गेटिंग एनी कंफ्यूज, हाउ टू आंसर these syllogism questions also very very important. So particularly in syllogisms concept, either or case is the most confusing and most of the aspirants are getting confused. So without getting any confused, in a simple way how to answer these questions, so to maintain good accuracy, that point we will discuss in this particular class. So if you watch this entire video till the end, you will get entire concept very easily. You can understand this particular syllogisms, either or concepts. So without wasting any time, directly we will move to the concepts. So that is syllogisms, either or concept from reasoning section. Here, my name is Anjaneyalu, the reasoning expert here. So directly we will discuss this particular concept very simple way. So you see, here we have, when we will take generally either or case. In a syllogisms, basically you will get some statements, minimum one or two statements, and based on statements we will get some conclusions, minimum one or two conclusions, or more than two conclusions you will get. So in these two cases, individually whenever we are checking first two conclusions, if both are right, directly you will take both are right. If only one is true, second one is false, we'll take only one is true, or only two follows, like this you will take. But in options, you will find either one or two. But when you have to select this option, when you have to select this either one or two option, this condition is very, very important. Now we see, without getting any confused, how to take this particular option, either one or two. To take this option, we have some condition. Whenever these condition follows, directly you can take either one or two options. So what are these conditions? Now you see, first condition, individually both the conclusions must be false. These given two conclusions must be false. Two conclusion must be false. Whenever only one is true, second one is false, directly you will take only one is follows. First one follows, second one is true, definitely we will take only two follows. If both are true, we will take both follows. But in next condition, next situation, if both are false, can you take directly neither nor? That's why when you have to take either or, when you have to take neither nor, this situation is very, very important. Once you understand all these concepts, when you have to take either or, when you have to take neither or, that is very simple way I'll explain here. So simply, when we will take these conditions, whenever minimum two conclusions are false, then you can check all these conditions. If two conclusions follows, first condition is satisfied. Next, second condition, elements must be same. Elements must be same. Elements means what? For example, if you have some A or B and no A is C. No A is C. For example, if you observe here, you have same elements here. A, same elements, but B and C different elements are there. But to get either or option, you have to take same elements. You have to get same elements. A and BB. Elements should be same. Elements should be same in both the conclusions. Whatever conclusions are false, in that conclusions, elements should be same. And third and last condition is what? Complementary pair should be there. This is very, very important condition. Most of the candidates are confusing only this point, right? Which are complement pair, which are not complementary pairs. Complementary pair is very, very important. So what is mean by complementary pair? Here, complementary pair means one should be positive and one should be negative. Positive means what? In a syllogism, so you will get these repeated words, all and some. These two are positive words. Clear? Negative means we have no and some not. So all these pairs generally we are taking as a complementary pair. One positive, one negative. If you observe here, we have some and no, positive and negative. Like this, we have one positive and one negative. That type of things we are taking as a complementary pair. But special conditions are there. All positive or negative pairs are not a complementary pairs. So what is that special conditions are there? Additional conditions are there. That is also you have to remember here. Now, so I hope everyone is clear. What are the conditions? Individually, both conclusions must be false. Elements must be same, and complementary pairs should be there. Now, very clearly, what are the other special cases about complementary pair? We'll discuss complete details about this complementary pairs. So generally, these are the pairs we will get from positive and negative words. First pair is all plus no, all plus some not, some plus no, some plus some not. These are the pairs. But here, if you observe clearly, all plus no is not a complementary pair. All plus no is not a complementary pair. Not a complementary pair. So don't bother about this. Whenever you are getting all plus no, even both the conclusions are false, even if elements are same, you'll get answer only neither one nor two. We don't get either or whenever we have all plus no combination. This is very, very important. So directly you obtain all plus no. If all other conditions are satisfied, definitely answer is only neither one nor two. Next, remaining three are complementary pairs. Remaining three are directly complementary pairs, but all plus some not, whenever we have all plus some not, if you observe here, two columns are there. First one, if elements are same side, if elements are opposite side, what is the meaning of this? For example, once you discuss different examples here, you will get more clarity. But we'll go to, before going to the examples, we will discuss the same point here. For example, some A are B, no A is B. If you have like this, another case, some A are B and no B is A, like this. If you observe first situation, A and B, B, these elements are same side. That is, we are taking as a parallel or same side. This one represents this one. And second case, opposite means what? A is this side and B is this side. Whenever we have like this, opposite side, elements are in opposite side, in all plus some not condition, if elements are opposite side, answer is neither or. In that case also, we don't get either or answer. In case all plus some not case, if elements are same side, answer is either or. These points also you have to keep in mind, otherwise you will get wrong answer. So when we are getting neither nor, all plus no, and all plus some not, if elements are reverse side, opposite side, this situation, answer is neither nor. So don't get confused, just remember this particular table, definitely you will get right answer. So to understand the more clearly, I'll take some more example based on all this situation. But without any doubt, remaining pairs, some no and some not, either elements are same side or reverse side, answer is only either or without any problem. You'll get only problem with all plus no is not a complementary pair, answer is neither or. All plus some not, if elements are reverse side, answer is neither nor. To understand all these examples, I am taking very simple example. To understand more clearly, let's see some example based on either or concept. Everyone can understand very easily. Now I am taking some example here. Statements, some A are B, some B are C. For this statement, first you have to draw the Venn diagrams. So some A are B, next to some B are C, some B are C. Here if you observe, I am representing, this is A, this is B. Some A or B means like this, you have to draw the diagram. Next, some B or C. Next conclusion is, next statement is, some B or C. Some B or C, some B or C. So like this, you can draw the diagram. Clear? So I'll take exact shape, right? So no problem. In actual exam, no need to draw these kind of perfect diagrams. So this is the actual diagram of this particular, some A or B, some B or C. This is a diagram. So using this diagram, how to answer given conclusion? Very simple way. Now we'll see everyone. First question, conclusion. All A or C according to the diagram false. No A is C is also false, because both the statements are complete positive. Negative conclusions are false. This shortcut method also we should know. If all the statements are positive, if any conclusion is negative, that type of conclusions are always false. But here both are false. Whenever both conclusions are false, you have to check either a condition. First condition, elements must be, both the conclusions must be false. Yes, both are false. Second one, elements should be same. A and CC, elements are same. Third one is what? Complementary pair. In a complementary pair, all plus no is not a complementary pair. That's why the first conclusion or first question answer is neither one nor two. Neither one nor two is the answer. All plus no. Clear everyone? Now we'll take same second question based on same diagram. What we have? All A or C is false. Next, some A or not C. Some A or not C. That is also false. If both are false, elements are same. Elements are same. Next, complementary pair. All is positive. Some not is negative. So, all plus some not according to the given table. As I told previously, all plus some not is a complementary pair. Right? If elements are same side, answer is either 1 or 2. Directly answer is either 1 or 2 for question number 2. Similarly, if you take question number 3, if you observe same diagram, according to the same statements, we are discussing all these questions. Now, all A or C, what is the diagram? A, B, C. This is the actual Venn diagram. All A or C is false. Some C or not A is also false. Elements are same, but reverse side, elements are same. Complementary pair, yes, some all plus some not is a complementary pair, but if elements are reverse side, answer is neither one nor two for question number 3. This clarity we require. Whenever we have all plus some not, if elements are same side, answer is either or. If elements are reverse side, answer is neither nor. So don't get confused. Next, another example we'll take to understand same concept. We have one more here. Now we'll see what we have. Some A or C is false. No A is C is also false. If both are false, check elements. Elements are same. Some plus no is a complementary pair. Some plus no. Whenever we have some plus no, even if elements are same side, if elements are reverse side, answer is only either 1 or 2. Either 1 or 2 for this fourth question. Fifth question also answer either or only you will get, because some A or C, no A is, no C is A. In these two questions, fourth and fifth question, conclusions are same. Just I change the elements reverse way. So elements are changed, elements are reverse side. Even though answer is only either or, if you have some plus no combination. I think very simple. Now simply, sixth and seventh questions also same concept. What is the actual diagram? A, B, C. This is the diagram. Now check these conclusions. Some A or C is false. Some A or not C is also false. What we are checking? Some plus some not complementary pair. Clear? Elements are same. Both are false. First condition is satisfying. Elements are same. Second condition is satisfying. Third condition, complementary pair. Positive and negative. Some plus some not is a complementary pair. In some plus some not, element same side or reverse side, answer is only either 1 are two without any doubt. Similarly, seventh question, in these two questions again conclusions are same, but elements I change in reverse. This is false, but elements are reverse side, but same complementary pair is there, even though answer is either one or two. Like this, you have to answer different situations. You can answer either or conditions very simple way. Just once you understand these conditions and this particular table, everybody can answer all type of either or questions very simple way. Try to remember this particular table very simple way. You can answer any type of either or questions in a simple way. I hope everyone is understood very clearly. So if you have any doubts in a comment session, you can comment me. I'll try to clarify your doubts. But you don't get any doubts. Once you watch this entire video, definitely you will get the clarity, because I covered all the conditions, all the complementary pairs, all the different situations, examples I'm already covered here. So other than these examples, we don't get any different type of questions in this particular either or concept. I hope everyone is clear with this either or concept very simple way. In a future, you can answer any type of syllogisms, either or case, very simple and easy way. Thank you, friends.